Hi children, welcome back to the IT class. In the last class, we discussed about keyboard and keyboard layout, text and the fingers used for typing various letters on the keyboard, right? At that time, we mentioned that we use those specific fingers to type various letters in order to make our typing faster and accurate. There are also various softwares that help us to practice typing. Let's start today's class by knowing about that softwares. Are you ready? Practice typing. To type quickly and accurately is a skill one has to acquire through practice. There are various software that help us to learn typing in a scientific way. KTouch, Tux Typing, etc. are examples of typing tutor software. Note that KTouch and Tux Typing are examples of typing tutor softwares, and these softwares teach us the method of typing fastly and accurately. Let's move to our next topic, word processor. We have discussed earlier that anything that we input into a computer is known as text. Now, there are numerous software which help us to prepare or process the text that we input into a computer in the way we wish to. These softwares are generally known as word processors. So children, what are word processors? Software which help us to prepare or process the text that we input into a computer is known as word processor. Now let's see some of the word processors and their developers. First one, LibreOffice Writer. The software was developed by the Document Foundation. Next, Microsoft Word. It was developed by Microsoft Corporation. Third one, Apache OpenOffice Writer was developed by Apache Software Foundation. And the last one, AB Word, was developed by AB Source Project. Children, you have to study this table carefully. Okay. Our next topic is other input methods. So far, we have discussed the input device keyboard and the way of entering text into the computer using keyboard. But there are many people around us who are not able to type using a keyboard. Similarly, there are some who cannot read the text displayed on the computer screen. Won't they have the need to use computers? Then how is it possible? Have you ever think of that? How is it possible for such people to use a computer? There are various ways to help such people to input text and read the matter displayed on the screen. Let's see. Text from books. The matter from a book can either be identified and read or converted to a text file in a computer using various software. Normally, it is done in the following way. Listen. The first step is to take an image of the page using scanner and save it in the computer. Instead of typing using keyboard, we can take the image of the page of a text using the input device scanner and save it into the computer. Okay, now the next step is to identify the characters in the image and change them to a text format like the one we get while typing using a keyboard. Clear? That is, actually, we typed the text using a keyboard, but if you are not using keyboard and use a scanner instead of keyboard, then we have to identify the characters in the image, that is in the photo of that page, and change them to a text format. There are software which can do this work very well. They are generally called OCR, Optical Character Recognition software. Leos available in our system is one such software, that is the software used for converting image into text format. It works based on the OCR software like Cuneiform and Tesseract. Okay, software that converts handwritten words on the screen of our mobile phone into text is very common these days. This is also an example of a software which identifies letter forms and converts them to text. Such a file which contains the data so converted can be used as an ordinary text file. So these two are regarding with the text from books. Now the other one is text from speech. Identify the words of a speech, converting them to text and feeding them into a computer is another method, that is speech to text. Such text input is done as follows. We have to input our voice into the computer using a microphone. So microphone is another input device which helps us to input our voice into the computer. Clear? Now we can convert the audio data that has been input in the computer into a text with the help of softwares. Sphinx, Julius, Simon, etc. are such speech recognition software for English. That is, these softwares, Sphinx, Julius, Simon, etc., identifies our speech, our words, and convert it into the computer. These are speech recognition software for English. They can identify English words only. Okay. Now you have to find out if there are any such software for Malayalam. That is any speech recognition software for Malayalam. Try to find it out. Okay children, it's time to wind up today's class. If you have any doubt, we can clear it during the online class. Okay. Thank you for watching.